Right, we're going to check in with Mike Yonne. He's live on location this morning. Mike's been off for a little while. Mm-hmm. He had a week vacation, and then you were on assignment last week, Mike. So we said, you know what we're going to do to him? We're going to lock him in a room and see if he can get out. So that's what you're
up to,
Mike.
It's my punishment, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Exactly. It's apparently my punishment for taking a little bit of time off. But yes, I am at the locked room this morning. It's a really cool new interactive game here in Calgary. You might have heard of this before because they were actually open for a few months. And then they decided, you know what, we're going to make things bigger, we're going to make things better. So the Locked Room is back, and in just a couple of weeks it'll be opening up to the public. And I love the concept behind this game. Want to introduce you to the gentleman, the co-owner of the Locked Room, Adil. Explain the concept for those who don't know. What is the Locked Room all about? Because it sounds very sinister.
You know what? A lot of people don't know what the Locked Room is, and the way I like to describe it is it's like the movie Saw, but a little more happy-go-lucky. You know, you leave with your limbs.
You don't have to cut off your leg or your ankle.
You know what? Maybe for the future, if we can pull that off, I'll attempt to. But for the moment, you leave alive.
So the concept is: you walk in with your friends, the door shuts, it is locked.
You and six of your friends, you're inside the room, you have 60 minutes, and you have to get out. And that's the whole concept. There's puzzles, there's interactivity, you gotta figure your way out of the room.
Now, there are a number of these, actually. I've heard about these in the States before. There are a few in Canada. This is the first in Calgary. You said this is kind of a growing trend, the interactive games. We're seeing more of this, and you guys are on the cutting edge, obviously being the first in the city.
You know, it's been growing like crazy. It starts from video games, you know, where we had interactive games online, and it's moving towards actual virtual inside the room games, and we're just upgrading it every year. It's just getting bigger and better.
Now, it's called the Locked Room, but it should really be called the Locked Rooms because, yes, we are standing in one of the rooms, but there are a number of different rooms, different themes that people can play.
You're bang on. You know, we're currently inside of Pirates, Mutiny of the High Seas, you know, where there's a current mutiny that occurred and you have to get out of the room. But, you know, we have two other rooms as well. So we're building more and more rooms as we go.
Who is this for? Is this for young people, old people? Is it scary?
You know what? We all kind of age ranges. It's about the ages of 12 all the way up to 50. You know, we get kids parties, obviously. We get the 20-year-olds and 30-year-olds. But we even get corporate events that they want to come out and do some team building.
I was going to say, this probably would be perfect for team building because you have to work together.
As a team, you're not just bowling one at a time.
Working together as a team, right?
Exactly.
Excellent. So I think we'll be exploring the Locked Room this morning, and I think the door, maybe we'll shut it. Maybe we'll lock ourselves in here for the next hour, and we'll take a look at some of the puzzles that you'd be up against here at the Locked Room. Jill, Ted.
Ooh.
I do not like confined spaces.
No, I don't know if I'd feel like that. Anxious.
Yeah, I don't know if I'd like that.
It's more exciting than a video game this morning.